Hello everyone, here we are again, Robin the Sudoku Guy with tutorial number 42, and this is a really important one for those of you who would like to challenge of advanced puzzles. I've been asked to do this by several people, so here it is. We're going to be covering two tutorials in the next 2 months. This one is about the XYZ wing, or XYZ wing, whichever country you come from. So let me show you what it's all about. Here we have not a puzzle, but an example of the XYZ wing. They call it a wing because there's two sections to it, as if you had a body of a bird and there were wings, but quite often the wing, one wing is very short. So I instead use the arms of a clock. The hands of a clock. You've got the hourly hand, which is usually shorter, and the minute hand, which is longer. Let's have a look at this one. I've got three examples here. This is an example of using a column. I'll also show you how to do rows. And it's going to be basically in vertical blocks. In this case, I'm using two blocks. In this case, I'm using three blocks, same here. But let's start off with this one. What the idea here is to watch for and spot, if you can, look for a cell which has three numbers, little numbers. And nearby in the same block will have another cell, which I'm going to call Y, which has two of the numbers that are in the X cell, which has got three little numbers. Now this X cell we call the pivot cell because it's like the middle of the clock, where this is the hour hand and this is the minute hand. Now, so we have one cell which has got 2, 3, 4 small numbers. In this block we have a 2, 4, which is also fits in with this cell, and up here we have a 3, 4, which also includes numbers of this cell. So you have now a sort of a 5 o'clock shape. But the key is that this cell Y is always in this part of the block, and the Z is always in line with the pivot cell. Now, once you've got that situation and you've discovered it, and that's a lot of fun, it takes practice, but once you get the hang of it, you pick them up quickly, is that if you have a number that's within this pivot cell that is repeated, but it is not a Y, in this case, it's in line with the column up to Z between, and it's also in this block, that 4 can be removed and you finish up with a 1. Now you may say, how do you know that? Well, I'll show you the logic a little later. Let's take this situation because the basic principles are the same. In this case, we have three blocks, vertical blocks, and we're looking for a cell which has three little numbers. In this case, we'll use 2, 3, 4 and again, and that would become what we call the pivot, the part of the middle of the clock where the arms go spread out. Now in this block we have a 2, 4, which is part of the block. It has to be in part of the block, but in this case it's straight across there. It could be here or here. And down here we have, in line with this column, a 3, 4. We call that the Z, or Z, depends on where you come from. Anyway, now that we've found a pivot cell and we've got a cell in the block that's got two of these numbers, and we've got a cell down here that's got two of these numbers, any other number, and this is important, in the X column that is not part of the XYZ, we can eliminate. So there's a 4, is 4 and a 4. The 4 can go. Now, why do I say 4 can go? Same situation over here. This is very important. when you're looking for an XYZ or Z, you are looking for a number which is repeated in each one of these cells. I forgot to mention that over here. This 4 is there, there, and there. It's in X, Y, and Z. And that's what makes up the X, Y, Z wing, as they call it. Now, let's go over to this one. We have another three vertical blocks in a slightly different position, but the principle is the same. We found here a 2, 3, 4. That would become the pivot. And we found over here a 2, 4. The 2, 4 fits into this one. In other words, it's repeating of two of those out of the three. And we found a 3, 4 down here, which we called the Z or Z. It still works. The principle is that this Y is still in this block which has the pivot. And the Z or Z is in the column where you have the 2, 3, 4, the pivot. If that is the case, and if you have another 4 in this block, and that's the key, 4 in here won't work. It has to be within this block and on the same row or column as the XZ, then that 4 can be removed. So that's looking at the XYZ system where you have a column. So that's it for this part. Don't go away. I've got more to show you. And then we got a real puzzle. Bye for now. Okay, here we are back again to show you how to do the XYZ wing when there's rows. The basic principles are the same, but you got to look at it sideways. Okay, revising, before I go on to this, I should point out that if you look underneath this video on YouTube, you will see that I've written a description, step-by-step way of where you can spot these. Spotting becomes much more difficult as you get into the more advanced puzzles. And it takes practice, and once you get the hang of it, you pick them up fairly quickly. So have a look underneath the video and you'll see I put in a step-by-step procedure on what to watch for when you want to look for these in hard puzzles. Okay, here I'm going to be showing you rows where the XZ is a row instead of a column. In each case, we've got one example here, one example here, one example here. We're using horizontal blocks this time. The basic principles are the same. You need to sort of look at it in different ways. Now, let's take this top one. We've used 3 blocks, which you can, and I've looked for and found a cell in this block, which is 2, 3, 4, 3 small numbers. I've also found in this block, but not in the same row, as the 2, 3, 4 here, a Y, which is these two numbers, similar to, fit in with these 2, 3, 4s. And now down here, we found a 3, 4, which is also be part of this 2, 3, 4. And very important, and this is something I want to emphasize, when you're looking for this pattern, you must make sure that you're looking for an X, Y, Z that has a common number. That is, the number 4 is in this one, and in this one, and in this one. And when you found that, now you're on the way. Once you've found it, you can use this as your, this becomes your pivot, and here's the arms of the clock, here and here. The key here is to look for, because 4 is the common number, is there a 4 in this row, in this block, that's not part of the XYZ wing? Yes, there is. And it's this one here, so we can eliminate that 4. And you're left with a 1. Now let's go to this one here. We found in this block, again, it was 2, 3, 4. And a 2, 4 here, and a 3, 4 here, So we have a 2, 3, 4, a 2, 4, and a 3, 4. Once you've found that pattern, you've got an X and a Y and a Z or Z. Then you know that this is the pivot. So you then can say any number in this block that is a 4 but is not part of the XY wing, you can remove it if it's in the row where the XZ is. Okay, let's do the same thing again here. The pivot, as I mentioned before, in this example, we're just using two blocks, is a 2, 3, 4, and elsewhere there's not three numbers. So, depends. Now that you've found this, you're looking for a number along here, a cell along here that's got a 3, 4, which is part of this one. Excuse me. And within this block, there's another one, which is a 2, 4. So the 2, 4 and the 3, 4 all relate to this pivot. And once you've found that, you know that if you've got a row like this with a Z and an X, anything on that row within this block, if it's a 4, it can be removed. Here it is. Oh, it becomes a 1.